Well, hello everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Jack Waldron's Euro Truck Simulator 2. You'll probably notice a few changes here. I'd bought a truck, and I had bought a standard truck off the shelf from the standard game, and I'd kitted it out the way I wanted it to be kitted out. I couldn't go any more than a 600 litre fuel tank, which was kind of bugging me a little bit, and I worked up a few more levels, but there was, you know, no more levels. I wanted a 6x4x2, and yeah, I was stuck at 600 litres of a tank, and kind of annoyed me. I wanted a 1,000 liter tank at least, and and it wasn't possible. So I went on to the mods to have a look, and I found some really nice mods, of which this is one of them. So I traded in my sweeted and up configured truck for this, which is Nactros MP4, which is she's quite nice and kind of liking her, and so I won't say it was. I didn't have enough money to keep the old one, which kind of disappointed me a little bit. But impatience, moreover, got the better of me, and I couldn't be arsed. I couldn't be arsed waiting. So I traded the old one in against this, thereby could afford this and still was left with enough money to upgrade my garage. And I still have how much? I still have 122,000 left in the coffers for you know, maybe buying another truck and hiring a driver and getting things started on that front. So I'm fairly pleased with this truck. I'm on my way to I got a 252 kilometer run. I've got a 4-hour run to pick up this next job, which actually is a little further than I anticipated. It's in Strasbourg. Why didn't I pick the job up in Stuttgart? Can I turn around here? I can. Might go back to Stuttgart because it's only going to take 5 minutes. I screwed up. The Mercedes garage is in Stuttgart, not in Strasbourg. And I wanted to take a job straight out of there. Check. No idea what you're doing at all, do you? So let's go up here and let's go back to Strasbourg and let's get ourselves organized a little bit more. Now, she's a nice truck. She's 680 brake, 680 horsepower. I don't know if it's brake horsepower. 680 horsepower, which is nice. I like the mirrors on her. The interior is updated interior, and it looks quite nice. Got GPS built in, so I don't need to download a GPS mod, which is cool. And I've got the iPod and the radio screen there, which is not showing up the GPS as well. One mod that I had earlier had the GPS on the main console, as well as the additional GPS as I have it here. That kind of just seemed a bit redundant. So this one's quite nice. Interior, the dash is yellow, which initially I was kind of thinking, yeah, I'm not so convinced about that. But honest to God, I don't mind it now. I changed the color of the seats back to black. I didn't want them yellow. But everything inside is kind of a light tan color, which brings a bit of light into the cab, I suppose. So we'll call that an acceptable deal. She's empty. Filled her up with fuel. No, she wasn't. She was filled up with fuel. She was 0 kilometers. There's 105 or 106 on her already. Dashboard is nice and clean in there. Control buttons, classic control buttons for a Mercedes steering wheel, they're a little crappy, to be honest with you. But I'm not going to be looking at them too much, and I don't really mind. We'll get to the yard and we'll have a look at her and see what I've done. But I'm happy. I've got a range now of what appears to be 3,660 kilometers per tank, and that's surprisingly good. I had a 600 liter tank in the other machine that would give me a range of 1,200 kilometers. So this is a 1,000 liter tank and it's giving me 3,600 kilometers. Which suggests I'm going to get 36 kilometers per liter. Something wrong there, isn't there? There really shouldn't be any way I'm getting anywhere near 36 kilometers per liter. What am I doing wrong here? Yeah, there's something not right there. Let's see what that number does as we proceed with our work. You can see that she's from Virtual Autotrans. That's the download that I can get. I'll try and remember to put a link in the bottom at some point in time. I'm just going to pull back into the Mercedes garage area here in Strasbourg, and just bring it around there and put the stuff in. It's even got the rain sensor right in the middle of the windscreen, which is kind of neat. Here's the truck details. So it has a 1,000 liter tank, 680 horses, retarder enabled engine, the GigaSpace 6x4 Actros MP14. So exactly what I was hoping to get somewhere in the game, and it's turning out to be a really lovely, really sweet truck. Really, really nice details on there, and generally fairly impressive by all standards. Now, we are here, and this is Stuttgart, so I need to look for a job that's in Stuttgart and not in Strasbourg, you dipshit. Right, so there's a Bratislava. Oh, one other mod that I've brought on, and you'll notice this from the prices. I've put in the difficult economy mod, which is reducing prices up to 80% and brings the costs down to something that's a hell of a lot more sensible. I'm kind of, I don't know, this is maybe taking full advantage of both systems. I've been using the standard economy of the game up until this point, and recently I kind of thought to myself, well, as soon as I earn enough money to buy the truck that I want, then I'll bring in a hard economy mod and put the numbers back down. So that's what I've done, because that's what I want to do. And so I own a 3-bay garage, I own one truck, and I have 122,000 in the account. And then it's taking it from there to build up the rest of the business from there. So you can see some deals. Here's a load of coal that is to be taken on a 4-hour jaunt, and I get just 4,500 for it, and it's a trailer. Diggers to Grimsby bring in 18.5 with a channel crossing, so that's a decent kind of run. Wood Shavings going up to Kiel brings in 9. There's an excavator for a short run that brings in 7. All of these are out of Stuttgart where I am. Some logs up to Belgium. So let's see, what am I going to do? Poland, that brings me over to Poland. Got Northern Italy here. Rotterdam, Southampton goes across there. Okay. Just goes up to Calais and pays 9. Here's an oversized digger that's going up to Amsterdam. Now this is a class 2 ADR, so it's a relatively short run, but it does pay quite nicely. And that looks like a nice tanker. 19 tons to Calais, pays 9, and that's an hour and 6, oh no, it's not an hour and 6 minutes, it's a standard delivery, oh here it is, so it's 556 kilometers and it's a 9 hour thing, so that suits me. I'll do that for the first run, because I should be an express stop in 8 hours, so. It's, where are we going? Going at the gate and left again. And we're going left here as well, and we do have the lights. To ask you to bear with me for 1 second as I check something out. That'll be a little bit better. So the engine is a little quieter now, so I don't have to shout so much, and hopefully not too quiet. This is done really well, and I'll put a link into the description below. So all credit to the guys behind this this particular mod. I think I'm going to stay with this for a while. I do quite like it. I mean she's just dead end right now, so she's light and she's handling quite nicely, but there's a nice feel about her. I like the mirrors, they're well done, they're nice and bright and clear and a decent size, and obviously fully adjustable and everything, so I can really set them for my liking. And the inside interior is done really well by and large. Am I dropping off here? I'm not. Have I just made another mistake? 2 hours and... Where the feck am I going? Currently have no delivery job. I'm going... Ah, Jesus. Well, we're going there this time. Go away. Don't know what the blazes I'm doing here. Oh, there are Denny. Everything is working, there's the retarder arm working, indicators work, and the brakes work. Freaking hell, come on people. Alright, we'll just pass you out because... A little impatient there, I know. A bit impatient, I'm a little bit impatient to get out of the way and going through it. Hurry up. So I'm pleased with this, and I think that it's fantastic that SCS is so modding friendly, and it is very fantastic that there's people out there with the skills to pull together this this mod. This is really sweet, and it's kind of everything that I want. How did they know that? You know, it's obviously well done. Whoever's been doing this mod knows what they're at, and you know, all credit to them. And like I say, the description will be in the link, or in the getting my mucking words waddled again. The link will be in the description. English is not that difficult, normally. I think this is the truck you're going to see me doing a little bit of driving on as we go forward. It's more modern, and still the Mercedes brand. I'm happy that there's a mod, but sure, there's a mod for all the different brands out there anyway, so it's not that much of a surprise. But it is pretty cool that I'm able to stay with that and get what I want. Because the standard fuel tanks that were available, at least for what I look for, with the model that I selected, and it was a Megaspace that I selected. 600 was the highest I could get up, and I didn't see anything that was higher as a standard model. Now, maybe there was some bigger tanks when you get up the levels, but I was getting a little impatient with trying to just climb the levels. I'd done quite a bit, and I wanted to move on, so that's what I've done. I've moved on, and we're driving this, and we're pretty cool. So I'll bring you back in a little bit later when something happens. So handy until then. There was a bit of an update, and look, there's a car that was on the wrong side of the road, causing us to come to a complete stop. And my Steam seemed to be pulling down an update to ETS2, and I believe that yesterday or the day before there was an update to 1.5.2 or something. So an update from the 1.4.x to 1.5.x. So I was hoping things like that might have been fixed when they talked about some tweaks to the AI traffic, some new cars and a few things, but obviously not. Or whatever Steam was doing, and it did pull down a fairly significant update, it was something else. So who knows? I don't have a clue. Not a tickety-tooty-tooty clue. Whatever a tickety-tooty-tooty clue is, I don't know, but anyway, that's what I don't have. More to follow soon. Go handy. Right, Heck's sake, I don't know what I'm doing, but I'm still driving to, which I think I'm still driving to Strasbourg. Do you know that? Or Stuttgart. I'm not. Oh man, life. I don't know what I'm doing. It looks like, well, I've got 2 hours and 40 minutes of driving still to go, 160 odd kilometers. So, I don't know what the hell the beginning of this video was all about. Maybe I'm just so giddy and excited about my new truck that I'm not able to concentrate at all. And it says 50 here, and we're in Europe, so that's 50 kilometers an hour, so I do need to slow down significantly for some reason, although the truck ahead of me doesn't seem to be slowing down. Whatever's going on there. No, he's gone flying through. You do have to stick your head around quite a bit with track IO to get your head out the window now. You still can do it though, that's fine. Yes. Not sure what the hell I was doing, but anyway. We shall be there at around 4:45, nearly 5 o'clock. To pick up. And I'll bring you back when something cool happens. Until then, go handy. Alright, as usual, I think I've confused myself again, and I have no idea. I was going up here into Steinbrück now, and we're going to pick up a load if they have one. And that's going to be our first load, no matter what it is. The GPS here is bringing me down this direction. But to be quite honest with you, I'm not even sure I went in the right direction. I don't know what I'm doing. So we're going to pretend that this was where I was going all along, and we're going to stop here, and we're going to see what jobs they have. And... oh, what a dipshit. So I've driven for a trailer of coal, or a trailer of sands, 23 versus 25. This is a 20... oh no, that expires in 20 hours. What's the details here? It's 1,000 kilometers all the way up to wherever that is, Rostock. This here is Interlinz. Interlinz brings me back into Austria, which means I can go and have a look-see at my garage. So we'll go there. Jeez, and I was going for a red tanker. Where the hell was... how the... oh. Never mind. Coal or sand. This is... whatever this is. This is awesome. What is it? It's sand. 25 tons of it as well, so it'll be a decent pull. Which is good, because, you know. It's a trailer, though. Trailers aren't pretty. But I don't mind trailers. Trailers are okay. Should be down here somewhere. There it is. There she be. Just a little trailer. She's 23 tons of sand. She's a Schmeid little cargo. So, not straight, but she's coming in on an angle, and she should connect up nicely there. But she did. So, it's a bit loud out here, so just a warning. Getting out in 3, 2, 1... Right, all is looking good. So, shall we away? Oh yeah, when I was here, I did want to, I wanted to take a photograph, yes. Yes, and I also wanted to fire up this and look at 3 hours and 50 minutes, and I've got an 11 hours and 59 to do, so... what's my map look like? I'm going there. So might as well drive for a few hours, I suppose. Yeah, I got an 11-hour driving window, and I've got 12 hours of driving to do, and I have shy of 4 hours remaining. I do have the ability to pull over here. This is a truck stop rest area here, but it's really no advantage. I might as well just get going. So I will. 23 tons is going to test her out a little bit. automatic box. She pulls nicely enough. Changes gear nicely enough. No idea what gear she's in though. That's missing, is it? An indicator. An indicator for the gear. Yeah, it is. Or maybe it's down there, is it? No, it's not. That's just my headlight. What the hell? There's no gear indicator on here. Isn't that interesting? Well, I suppose you don't need a gear. Although I do like to know. Well, I suppose you see, those automatics just tell you that you're in drive. And it's, you know, you go into the Tiptronic or whatever and kind of manually select a first, second, or third. Anyway, we're away. We'll probably be pulling over somewhere in a little while. First opportunity we get. But this is the first load. It's a load of sand in a trailer, and we've got a wee distance to go before we get to Linz. And I got 3.5 hours driving left from now, and 11¾ hours, roughly of a distance to travel. So catch you later. Go handy. Okay, well, I'm just about to pull in and grab some rest here because I've got 2 hours of driving left and 10 hours 31 of a distance, so I'll be able to take a rest here and do the remainder of the journey in a full stint. I don't need any fuel, I just need to pull over. But if you look at my fuel count now, my range is 1800 kilometers because I'm under load and I'm pulling 23 tons. So I'm impressed with that, because now I'm in the region of, well, 18 divided by 8, call it 850 liters for argument's sake, and call it 1900 kilometers. 2.5 is 17, so that's a little bit more than, what is that, that's 11 and maybe a little bit less than 12 kilometers. Per liter, excuse me, 2.2 kilometers, 2.3 kilometers, I'm making the numbers up a little bit now, but 800 goes into 1800 twice, leaves 200 over, so that's a quarter, so 2.2, 2.3 liters, 2.3 kilometers per liter, get this right, Jack, that's getting in the region of 10, yeah, 11, maybe 12 kilometers per gallon, which is about 8 to 9 miles per gallon, which is decent, which is about right. So, God, that was hard work, wasn't it, and painful to listen to. But when I did see 3,600, I was thinking, holy shit, that's not right. But that was empty. So the game does account for whether you're empty or whether you're pulling a load, which is pretty cool. So I'm pleased about that. So, yeah. Anyway. I can't do math anymore. Listen, catch you later, go handy.